Welcome guys to the world of unboxing reviews and tutorial. Today, I'm gonna show you how I built this rig. Let me show you first how to use this rig. First, let's unmount it from the tripod, then mount it on my shoulder. Make sure that your body is the one who's carrying the weight and not your hands or arms. You can attain the balance by adding a counterweight at the back. For my counterweight, I've used a V-mount battery. Serves as a counterweight because it's heavy, and at the same time I use this as an external power supply for my camera and other electronic devices. After you rest the camera rig on your shoulder, hold the wooden handle. This is actually from Cambait, so it's a wooden handle from Cambait and it has a rosette, so this means that you can easily change the angle of the wooden handle. Of course, you can customize the position of the handle for a more comfortable hand position. And of course, it will depend on your shooting style and of course your shots. Since the camera rig sits comfortably on your shoulder, you can easily let go of any of your hands to adjust the follow focus, the zoom ring, and of course, to make changes in your camera settings. What I like about this rig is my eyes is in line with the monitor, the LCD, the camera, and the monitor on top of my camera, the external monitor. This means that I can easily see all the camera controls and can easily monitor my framing because it's in front of my sight, and I can easily change the settings. I've used the offset bracket from small rig to be able to offset the extension towards my right shoulder. Since it has a top handle, I can also change the camera levels by grabbing the top handle and move it at my waist level. Your stance should be left foot forward and right foot backwards. So this stance is ideal for faster movement and stability. You can also use your hips to have 3 points of contact. What I like about my setup is it's very modular, meaning I can transform the shoulder rig to a normal handheld camera rig quickly. I just need to remove the two wooden handle and extension rod at the back. So to loosen the wooden handle, just rotate counterclockwise the knob. So by removing those handles on the front and the extension at the back, you easily transform your camera into a handheld rig. So I can also take off the camera from the cage itself and put it on a gimbal by just loosening the cold shoe on the top as well as the quick release Manfrotto plate at the bottom. But since I'm using a follow focus and a lens support, I need to loosen this up so that I can remove the camera easily. Because if I don't do that, this will prohibit the camera to be pulled from the cage. As you can see, my shoulder rig is built in three principles. Number one, it should be modular. Number two, it should be comfortable. Number three, it should have a good ergonomics. Modular, I can make it as sophisticated and as simple in a minute to fit my shooting requirements. Comfort, it is well balanced and it rests comfortably on my shoulder without straining my arms. My body do all the works in lifting this camera rig, which is better because it's near the center of my gravity. And our body is much stronger than our arms. Ergonomics, I can easily reach or access all the camera controls. Also, I can monitor my shot easily because the camera and the monitor is in line with my eyesight. Now, I'm gonna show you the components that I added to my handheld camera rig to make it a shoulder rig. Okay, the soul of the rig is the camera cage. So I got the camera cage from Nice Rig Half Cage. Here is a universal cage. So I pick half cage because the camera grip is good and comfortable already. And it has all the essential buttons. I don't want any obstacle prohibiting me from accessing the camera controls freely. I also don't like a cage that blocks my sight from the camera controls. If you want to learn more about the Nice Rig Half Cage, you can watch my previous video for a more comprehensive review. Okay, so the next is the small rig base plate. It's simple and low profile plate. This is used to be able to mount the 15mm rods. Though I've added a generic cheese plate to elevate the entire rig so I can be able to mount it on the tripod because the rosette is hitting the tripod head. For the rods, I've used two kinds of rods, 12 inches rod in the front and a shorter rod at the back, around 6 inches. So the rods are the key for you to be able to add additional accessories. So these rods are the key on building a sophisticated rig. Okay, on the front, I've attached a follow focus. It's from 7 Oak. It's big and heavy duty. It has hard stop, which is essential for setting the right focus. You can mount and unmount this follow focus on the rad easily by unhooking or hooking it on the rad. If you're going to attach a follow focus, make sure it is partnered with a lens support. This lens support will prevent any movement. This lens support provides another point of contact to your camera so that your camera will not move or twist. Furthermore, this will also remove some of the stress from the camera mount, especially if you're going to use a longer and heavier lens. At the back, I've used an offset bracket from Small Rig and a shorter rod to mount the shoulder pad from 7-Oak and the counterweight, which is the V-mount battery. I did not remove the side grip because it provides an additional mounting for my Rode mic. Besides, it's better to have a multi-grip, and I like it because it's thick and smooth. It fits my hands really well. So to conclude, this shoulder rig is very modular, comfortable, and ergonomically wise. I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed building my rig. It actually took me a lot of time, days, for me to fine-tune my shoulder rig. So that's all, folks. So if you find this helpful or entertaining, please don't forget to like, subs, and share. Bye.